Okay, class. Chapter 10 na tayo. Bilis ng panahon. So, let's finish this one. Alright, final chapter, chapter 10. Introduction to Manufacturing Business. Buy, produce, sell. The manufacturing form of business is the broadest among the three types of businesses according to activity. Aside from the buying and selling activities, unique to a manufacturing entity is the production phase, which makes it more complicated as well. First, a manufacturing concern has to buy raw materials. Second, labor is procured and applied and other costs are incurred. Finally, finished product is sold to customers. So, recalling, we have three kinds of businesses according to activity. Tama? You have your service business, you have your merchandising or buy and sell business, and then finally, you have your manufacturing. Raw materials are those that will be used to which labor will be applied to come up with the so-called finished product. So, later on, we will delve deeper on that. Accounting for the purchase of raw materials and sales to customers are similar to that of a merchandising concern. Of course, with the distinction that under merchandising concern, purchased inventory are for sale without alteration, while accounting for sales to customers are substantially the same. Correct. So, yung primary difference ng merchandising doon sa ating manufacturing is that the merchandising entity does not alter. Hindi niya binabago. Binili mo, then ibibenta mo as is. Okay? It should be mentioned that the above are just simplified description of the general activities and sequencing of such activities of a manufacturing concern. That is just in simple terms. Okay? To have a deeper insight, complications may arise since making a product usually requires several raw materials. This means that the purchasing department will have to deal with different kinds of suppliers. Correct. When orders arrive, the receiving department may also have to inspect the several raw materials. Also, to say the least, sufficient labor must also be secured, especially when highly skilled technical labor force is needed. Ayan. It is during the production stage that most of the costs are incurred. Here, close monitoring and proper accounting of costs are critical since costing directly affects pricing. Tama yun. Kasi usually, companies price their product based on the cost. Yun yung tinatawag natin sa MAS na cost-based pricing. Kapag sinabing ang cost ay 10 piso per unit, a company may decide to add 20% based on that, such that the pricing will become 10 times 1.20. So, ganun yun. Kaya sabi natin dito, the cost directly affects the pricing. Much of the activities cited above are tied to the concept of forecasting and budgeting. You will take this up in your higher accounting subjects, particularly managerial accounting and your cost accounting. Okay? All of this will be discussed in higher accounting subjects. Cost classifications in broad terms. So, nabanggit natin that there are two information systems that usually exist in a company. Yun yung financial accounting, yun yung managerial accounting. So, dito, under financial reporting, the two broad cost classifications are product cost and period cost. So, more of this, mas maganda sana kung matuloy natin yung discussion sa cost accounting. Ano? Titignan natin. But, we have to finish this one first, okay? Direct materials, direct labor, and overhead under the product cost. Prime cost is the combination of your direct materials and direct labor. Pag naman ang pinagsama, yung direct labor at saka yung overhead, ang tawag doon ay conversion cost. Pag sinabing product cost, all of those costs that are incurred which are attributable and are capitalizable into the product. Pag naman sinabing period cost, these are costs that are expensed as incurred. Okay? Expensed as incurred. Example, yung selling expenses, administrative expenses, all of those are under the caption period cost. Okay? Product cost and period cost. For purposes of determining product cost, all costs incurred in acquiring, tulad ng sinabi natin kanina, and making a product are classified under product cost. So, tulad ng sabi natin, all of those that are attributable in the acquisition and in the production of the product are classified under either direct material materials, direct labor, or overhead under the product cost category or caption. Alright? Ayan. Product costs are initially assigned to inventory accounts, raw materials, work in process, and finished goods. So, nabanggit na dito. Okay? One of the more unique characteristics of a manufacturing concern compared to a service and merchandising concern is the existence of three types of inventory. So, as I stated, raw materials inventory, work in process inventory, and finished goods. So, wag nating masyadong i-preempt yung discussion mamaya. So, let's proceed na muna for now. All costs that are not product costs are classified under period cost. So, parang catch basin definition siya. Lahat daw ng hindi product cost, period cost. Manufacturing cost. Okay? Number one, direct materials. Raw materials are those that go into the final product and thus become an integral part of it and the cost of which could be traced into the finished product. Raw materials could either be direct or indirect. So sa number one, ang main focus natin yung direct materials. Yung raw materials na term is a more general term because it encompasses both direct materials and indirect materials. Pag sinabi nating direct materials, those that can be conveniently traced because they form an integral part of the item or the final product, they fall under the so-called direct material. So say for example, yung mga fingerprint sensors daw sa mga smartphones natin, yung wood sa paggawa ng cabinet, yung ink tank sa mga printer, at tulad ng mga iba't iba pang examples that could be conveniently traced into the final product. Yung term na convenience, okay, mahalaga yun kasi pagka inconvenient siya to trace into the final product, tulad ng sabi dito, tulad ng binding glue na gamit sa books, thermal grease gamit sa microprocessors, yung mga yun kasi ay very insignificant as to amount and as to cost, which makes it very inconvenient to be traced dun sa costing process ng final product. At pagka nagkaganon, inconvenient to trace and very minimal yung quantity or amount, indirect material siya. Okay? Pagka direct materials, it is its own caption, direct materials. Pagka indirect materials, siya ay falling under number 3, manufacturing overhead. Tulad ng sabi dito. Okay? Indirect materials are included as part of manufacturing overhead. The finished product of one company may also be the raw material for another company. Correct, tama? Yung ginawa ng ibang company, gamitin mo din as a raw material, particularly direct material, to make your own finished product, then it becomes your raw material.
When teachers like me teach in front of a live audience, we derive satisfaction to some extent from the interaction with students. Yung mga simpleng pagtawa mo sa mga jokes namin, they mean something to us. They make us happy. But teaching in front of the camera is a different thing. We don't even know if you're there. We don't even know if you're listening. So a simple like dun sa ating video or a simple present, sir, nandito po kami, nakikinig, we are watching, sir, will inspire us. When teachers like me teach in front of a live audience, we know that you're there. But teaching in front of the camera is not merely sharing our content. It means sharing our time, our devotion, and above all, our passion. So, yung simpleng pag-subscribe mo sa amin, it lets us know that you are there and we are here to continue what we are doing. So, ngayon pa lang, nagpapasalamat na kami. Diyan sa yung subscription, it inspires us. It inspires me to wake up every morning, prepare discussion materials, and continue what I am doing. So, thank you so much. Please continue sharing and liking and subscribing. Thank you.
Sabi dito, example, si Lenovo, which is a popular Chinese brand, ina-outsource lang na yung kanyang DVD drives kay Sony. Okay? Si Apple, kumukuha ng product galing kay Beats. Apple has recently announced that it will be using Beats in its final product, which are iPhones, MacBook Airs, MacBook Pros, etc. Number 2, direct labor. Consists of labor costs that can be conveniently traced to the finished product. Okay? Pansin mo, conveniently traced to the finished product again. Because if the labor cost is very insignificant as to quantity and as to amount, they will fall under number 3 or manufacturing overhead. So ngayon pa lang, may idea ka na, okay, that number 3, manufacturing overhead, is a catch basin definition. Sasabihin sa'yo later on dito, all of those that do not fall under number 1 and number 2 will necessarily be manufacturing overhead. Yeah. So number 2 tayo, direct labor. Examples, yung pasahod mo sa workers, okay, yung labor cost ng electrical wiring in a construction compensation, site, or the salary of a shoemaker, all of these are falling under direct labor costs. Number three, manufacturing overhead includes all manufacturing costs except direct materials and direct labor. So, catch basin cost classification or definition, right? Non-manufacturing costs, nabanggit na natin ito kanina, you have your selling cost and administrative cost. Selling cost, as the word itself suggests, selling, all those that are incurred in selling. So, say for example, yung sales agent's commission, ayan, a depreciation of the selling equipment, so iingat ka sa depreciation, ha? Depende kung anong dinedepreciate mo. Pagkang dinedepreciate mo ay gamit sa selling, papatak yung depreciation expense sa selling cost. Pagka naman ang ginagamit, ang dinedepreciate mo ay yung gamit sa opisina na hindi ginagamit sa sales, o sa pagbibenta ng product, then such depreciation expense would fall under administrative expense. Ayan. Administrative costs include all costs associated with the general management and administration of an organization. Ayun yun. Prime cost and conversion cost. So, as we have stated kanina, ano na nga ba yung prime cost mo? Prime cost is the combination of your direct materials and direct labor. And conversion cost is direct labor and overhead. Ayan. Two or more categories are often used in the discussion, prime and conversion cost. Prime cost is the sum of your direct materials and direct labor. Conversion is the sum of your direct labor and manufacturing overhead. The term conversion cost is used to describe direct labor and manufacturing overhead because these costs are incurred to convert the materials into finished product. Yeah. Direct and indirect costs. If a cost is particularly traceable to a specific activity, then such cost is direct. Kailangan mag-pay attention ka, makinig kang mabuti. Why? This is a prelude to one of your, actually not just one of your subject, okay? At least two of your subjects, particularly cost accounting. Parang introduction ito dun sa cost accounting mo. Siguradong magkakaroon ka. Pagka narating mo yon, you will find that this chapter 10 is very important. And of course, your managerial accounting, okay? Pag sinabing indirect cost, yan yung mga cost na titigil pagka yung activity ay tumigil din, okay? Because such cost is direct to that activity. Indirect costs are usually allocated cost. Why? Because maybe the activities to which they relate, okay, madami yung activities na gumagamit dun sa cost such that if you stop one of those activities to which they relate, hindi titigil ng buo yung indirect cost. Okay? Once again, if you stop the activity and the cost stops, direct cost yun. If you stop an activity and the cost does not stop, indirect cost yun. Ganun yun. Okay? Ayan. Next, cost flow in a manufacturing business. You have your cost here. You have your statement of financial position or your balance sheet. You have your statement of profit or loss. Alright? So, tulad nung na-discuss natin kanina, under product cost, you have your direct materials, direct labor, and your manufacturing overhead. But to show here, una muna, you have to purchase the raw materials. Tulad ng sabi natin kanina, the term raw materials is a broader term than the direct materials. Kasi pag sinabing raw materials, pwedeng manggaling dyan yung direct at saka yung indirect. Alright? So, from the raw materials, so hugutin mo yung materials papunta doon sa factory, doon sa gawaan. Okay? Then, papasok siya doon sa materials inventory account. A-applyan ng direct labor, manufacturing overhead, yung work in process, which we will define right here. Okay? And then, your period costs, which are your selling and administrative costs. These are expenses as incurred. Then, after the work in process is finished, you'll proceed to the finished goods inventory. The cost will proceed to the finished goods inventory. To the cost of goods sold, less the cost of goods sold is an expense account, okay? Combined with the selling and the administrative expenses to determine our net income or net loss for the period. So, i-define natin para mas lalo nating maintindihan yung cost flow natin dito sa taas. Distinct to a manufacturing business are three inventory categories tulad ng nabanggit natin kanina. First, materials inventory. This shows the balance of the cost of the unused materials. This account shows the cost of materials that have been purchased but not yet used in the production process. Dahil tulad nga ng sabi natin kanina, pag nagamit na yung direct materials, ni-request na siya dun sa production department, papasok na siya dun sa work in process. The work in process is an accumulation of cost from the direct materials, from the direct labor, from the manufacturing overhead, which forms part of an accumulation of, it is a representation of some something which is not yet finished. Okay? Yan yung mga nasimulan na hindi pa natatapos. Work in process inventory ang tawag natin doon. So, work in process, tulad ng sabi natin, shows the manufacturing costs that have been incurred and assigned to partially completed units of production. Okay? Number 3, finished goods inventory. Shows the costs assigned to all completed products that have not been sold. This account shows the cost of the product that is complete and ready for sale. Pagka nabenta na siya, papasok na yung cost. Lalabas na siya from the finished goods inventory, papasok siya dun sa cost of goods sold account natin. A manufacturing cost flow is the flow of direct materials, direct labor, and manufacturing overhead through these accounts and into the cost of goods sold account. A well-defined manufacturing cost flow is the foundation for accurate product costing. Correct. Accurate inventory valuation and financial reporting, of course. It supplies all the information necessary to prepare a statement of cost of goods manufactured and compute the cost of goods sold. Ayan. So, ito yung ating journal entries. I-rotate lang natin saglit. Zoomin natin ng konti. Ayan.
Okay, class. So, that's the bell already. That's it for this meeting. So, ganun-ganun lang, class. A few minutes of your time every day, imbis na kung ano-ano yung pinapanood mo, just make it a habit to watch our videos bilang tulong na rin dun sa sarili mong pag-aaral. Why? Kasi tatandaan mo, hindi lahat ng nababasa mo ng mag-isa ay maririnig mo. At hindi din lahat ng mga naririnig mo ay mababasa mo. Tulungan yan. So with that, see you in our next meeting. See you in the next lesson.